powers.
Hey, yo, mad. It's myself, 100 Eyes, from the Powerful Breakfast Show, and we are live at Grenfell Tower, 5th anniversary. What a tragic accident it has been. But today, we are live on the ground, looking to find the real opinions from the people that live in the community. Let's go.
Lord, they hurt thy soul, and they won't let me be free. Cause Lord, they hurt thy soul, yeah, and they won't let me be free. What?
I'm Sister Ruth, a county line. I'm for Grenfell.
Are you for Grenfell?
I live right in front.
How are you doing?
Thank you for having me.
You know, I've been nearly every country of the world for charity as a Catholic nun. It's the worst thing I ever saw in my life.
This tower falling. Is it right to give you a quick
I'd love to.
It's myself, 100 Eyes, on the Powerful Breakfast Show, and I am here with a fellow...
Sister Ruth.
How are you doing, Sister Ruth?
I'm not drunk yet. I'm only 81.
It's a bit early, isn't it, sister?
Not really, but don't tell the Pope he thinks I'm a holy nun.
So are you a legit sister?
Yeah, I've worked nearly every country of the world for charity.
Yes.
Now I live in front of Grenfell Tower. It's the worst thing I ever saw in the world.
Okay. Where was you at the night? Where it happened?
I live right in front. I saw it from the start. Enormous flames. Yes. I ran to Latimer Church next door.
Okay.
And hundreds of Moroccan Muslims were running and sobbing and howling.
Oh.
They had thrown their babies out of the window.
Oh.
And no one caught them. It's not their fault. So 500 died, not 72, 500. My two African carers, who were wonderful, died in there. I pray to them every day.
So why are they saying 72, there's 500?
Because they caused the fire and they should be in prison. They're criminals.
Who caused the fire?
TMO landlords, they refused 500 tenants for 10 years a fire alarm, a fire escape, and a fire extinguisher. And they covered it with unlawful covering. They caused the fire.
The cladding you're talking about, right?
Well, and everything else that I've just said.
Oh, wow. What was your first feelings when you saw the fire that night?
I was absolutely stunned. I've been all around the world, see, not the worst thing I ever saw in my life.
Yeah.
I couldn't eat for 5 years after. Now I started to eat again.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I was with all these sobbing, howling Muslim mothers who sob and howl when they're grieving.
So what about the day after? What was the vibe like the day after the fire?
Well, it took a long time. I live in front, and it's been 5 years. I've worked with all the grieving people who lost their parents and their children and their relatives and their friends. It's horrible.
It's horrible.
Still.
Yes. So how do you think this community can move on?
I think this, I'm very proud of this community. I've been around the world and I've lived here 16 years.
Yes.
I'm very proud of this community. They've been very generous and very kind and very unified in supporting everything here.
Yes.
I'm proud of them.
Yes. And what can the people do to help out with the cause?
I think the first thing they can do is to pray. I think that's the most important thing. And if they meet any grieving person, there are loads of grieving people,
yes,
they can talk to them and comfort them and donate food and drink and supplies, clothes, to the two shrines I built, one by Latimer Church and one by this leisure centre.
What's their names, the shrines? What are they called?
Latimer Shrine by Latimer Church and Leisure Centre Shrine.
Okay.
They can give food, drink and clothes to people still grieving. That's what I do every day.
Do you think they're going to let us in to the building, into the little forecourt or not? I do hear the choir in there.
Yeah, sorry, who will let you in? Who?
I don't know.
This is what I'm told. They said at 4 o'clock they're having a memorial service at the foot of the tower, so I'm going there at 4 o'clock.
Okay, I want to be there with you. We're
going to
stand.
Thank you. Thank you for your work.
We're going to stand in solidarity.
Of course, thank you. Do you want to say anything else?
No, I'm good, thank you very much. Do you want to say anything?
God bless everyone who's watching. Please pray for all of us and donate things to the two shrines. God bless you all, Sister Ruth, with love and prayers.
Oh, thank you very much, sister.
What country are you from?
I'm from Sierra Leone.
Oh, I've been there.
I'm from Sierra Leone, yeah.
God bless you.
You? What country are you from?
I've got 11 races in me.
No way.
Yeah, I have, including Trinidad.
Oh, wow.
5 religions, Jewish, Hindu, Iraq, Muslim, Protestant, Catholic.
Make some time to love. Take some time to serve. To make a better place for the children of tomorrow. We've got to learn to love again. We've got to learn to love again.
Good afternoon, all. My children couldn't be here they couldn't be here, so I'd like to represent them by reading out their poems. I really want to say thank you to Committing Arts and for Empress for putting on those workshops that help the children to heal. With poetry, they were able to share their feelings, and I'm grateful to be sharing this with you today. So my son, he was 8 at that time, and he wrote, "In the dark of night. In the dark of night, there will be light. Everything is bright, even at the dark of night. At day, it is always bright, but not in the dark of night. The dark spreads itself, mocking everyone, but even in the dark of night, the light still appears. In the dark of night, there will be light forever. Dark with night, light with day, dark and night, never without light." That's by Elias Chaffin.
Way down to the ground. I hear the words of I am and say, what does he say? Babylon, you're thrown gone down. Hey, Babylon, you're thrown gone down. Now I hear the angel with the seven seas. Babylon, your throne gone down.
Down.
Oh, Babylon, your throne gone down.
I am mad. My Soul 100 Eyes from the Past for Breakfast Show, and I am here with the wonderful
Omar Gomari. This is OG as my highest name as well.
OG, yo, Mr. OG here, put on a beautiful event for the community today, representing the 5th anniversary of Grenfell. And I can't even say it, man. It's a sad thing. So, what made you put this event on today? And what's the objective?
So my objective is to help the people in the community and help people say what they want to say, because it's coming up to 5 years and some people were, they felt like they couldn't speak, but now I've designed this place where we can stay in the grass and we can make people speak and let people say what they want to say, let people have a place where there's no media, no nothing, they can just relax and calm down as well.
Okay, where was you on the night? What happened?
I was right in that corner there.
Tell me your thoughts and feelings.
My thoughts and feelings is when I tried to go and help my friend, the police stopped me. They had shields, so I couldn't go and save my friend. He had to push my friend to get to his family.
Oh, wow. Oh, Lord. So your friend survived though, yeah?
Passed away.
Oh! Sorry, Babo. Sorry.
The whole family passed away, so it was. I don't want to say the names, but there was two people that. There was two boys. One was young, one was older. He was my friend. And then there was a sister as well. And what I went through. I still go to counselling now because every time I look, I work right next to the tower as well. So I live right next to the tower and I work next to the tower. So I work in Kensington Leisure Centre. So when you go past there, you see a sports centre right next to the tower. Like,
I see it. Went past it.
So yeah, that's where I work. But let me tell you something now. I will fight for these people till the death of my life. You understand? I will fight for my community. I'll fight for my community to be one community. I'll fight for everything in this world for my community, because the people in the tower, when you're sad, when you're down, they will come say hello to you. They won't just walk past you. You understand? So, this is why I'm here for them. I do something like this to respect them, so everyone comes together and respects the people that passed away.
Oh, bro, it's a beautiful thing, bro. Look at all these people, bro. You brought them all together today. You did that. Sorry to say this, yeah, but I've been talking to a lot of people around here, and they're saying it's not 72 people that died. How much people have died, bro?
This is, I made it 72 on my t-shirt. The government, if I've done more than 72, the government will try and put me in prison.
Are you joking?
Because we know there's more than 72 people. There's 72 people plus.
Why are they going to put you in prison, bro?
Because the people bereaved signed the paper to say a disclaimer.
Thank you very much.
That's what I'm going to say for now.
All right, last question, bro. How do you think this community can get past this issue here?
Someone going to prison.
Sorry?
Someone going to prison.
They can't handle it.
someone going to prison.
Oh, I see. Someone going. To, someone needs to get. Need to get justice, basically. Yeah. Who needs to go to prison?
The people who designed that cladding. The people in the council. RBKC. I'll say it right. RBKC.
Thank you, Omar. Thank you very much, yeah. Hey, thank you for putting us a bit, yeah. You're good, you. Thank you.
That's the script in the life that we live. No one will take her soul. And they won't let me be free. Cause Lord, they hurt thy soul. Yeah. And they won't let me be free.
Played out. You gotta separate from the fakes now. Cause what they don't say is you gotta stay woke when you lay down. These boys will kill you, even though you know them since the playground. This be the error for the fakes now. Cause them fakes drag your name down.
Are you mad? Myself 100 Eyes from the Pass for Breakfast Show, live at Grenfell 5th anniversary, and I am here with Joe.
Hello.
How you doing, Joe?
Yeah, not too bad. Not too bad. Bit fed up. 5 years on, no arrests. But hey, there you go.
Whereabouts do you live?
Just here. Lancaster West Estate, Barrenden Walk. Just up there where that green thing is hanging over the wall.
Could you feel the heat on the night?
From where you were?
I was on my way to bed when it happened. I saw the lights outside, yeah. And I knew at about 1:27 in the morning that people were going to die in that tower. Because I tried to declare a major incident.
How long ago?
That was on the night, so it was within about 35 minutes of it starting.
Oh.
My full statement's on the inquiry website. If you use my full name, Thomas Joseph Michael Delaney, you can see it.
Okay.
Yeah, even my 999 calls there, I tried to call it in as a major incident.
Yeah.
But, you know, and it's ridiculous. If this had been 72 MPs who died,
yeah,
5 years ago, we'd have had convictions that day.
Facts. So, the inquiry is next week or next month? The
inquiry finishes next month, phase two of it. But, you know, I didn't see a point in starting phase two when we ignored all the recommendations from phase one.
Who ignored it?
Well, the government did, didn't they? Why come up with another phase worth of recommendations when you've already got a whole heap over there that you haven't implemented?
It's to buy time, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. You know, I think it's since 1980, we've had 68 public inquiries, and of those, only three or four of them have had all of their recommendations implemented.
You're joking.
You know, just look at the cost. Look at the cost of that. This inquiry is estimated to hit 150 million this year, and it'll be 250 by the time it's done.
Wow.
If each one is that, you know, we're talking billions of pounds wasted on lawyers for recommendations that we then ignore.
What about the tower itself? What's going to happen to it?
The government want it torn down. Personally, I want it to stay because, you know, if in 10 or 15 years' time we're digging tumours out of ourselves because we've got some crazy cancer,
yeah.
I'd like to be able to test that damn thing and see if that's where it come from.
Oh,
you know,
God.
So you can build an exoskeleton around it, give us four vertical gardens on each side. Keep it inside as a shrine for the dead and keep the outside looking good for the rest of us.
Before it burnt, there was talks about it was an eyesore.
It was called the poorer cousin of the academy that's just there in the sports centre.
Poorer cousin? I've never heard that.
You can tell these are rich people, so it's all about what their cousins are up to. What the aunts and uncles do.
That is disgusting.
Yeah.
That's disgusting, so. So, how much people would you say really died on the night? Because officially they're saying 72.
Officially it was 70 on the night and two later on, but I would estimate, I mean, there are people where we don't even know who were in the flats.
Of course.
There's some people we don't even know their surnames, which I think is a scandal. But how are you charging council tax to these people when you don't know their name? Well, you see, so I mean, personally, my estimate would be it was probably something between 1 and 150. Particularly given with the amount of people who went missing.
So why did you not say 150?
Well, because we would have rioted. If it had been 150, we'd have gone and ripped Theresa May out of Downing Street, you know, and probably beaten her all along the streets around here or something.
Was there any form signed to say that it's officially 72?
Yeah, that's what the inquiry have found. It's officially 72. But, you know, there was 8 to 10 floors of that thing that burned hotter than a crematorium. Crematorium burns at 1600 degrees Celsius. They burned at 18 and 1900 degrees Celsius for at least like 6 to 8 hours. You know, you don't know what was lost in that time.
On the night, did you come out?
Yeah, I was out here. We were throwing stuff up at windows, and I bitterly regret that now. It's like, why do we wake people up? We woke them up to die.
Oh, sorry.
It's just not your fault. You should, but, I mean, that's a brutal thing to say, but we should have just left them in bed. At least they would have died in peace that way.
Joke.
No, I mean, that's a terrible situation to be in.
So how does the community move on from this disastrous event?
We need people in jail. That's what we need. We need people in jail. You know, we saw people in jail in 2010 for the London riots when we had 24-hour a day courts.
Yeah.
You know, to get people who'd stole trainers from Night Town or whatever. You know, so why can't we have even 5 or 10% of that effort now for this?
Are there people pushing for it?
Of course, sir. We've been pushing for it since the start, but, you know, what good is it? The police, we can't make the police do their jobs, can they? They'd rather come and bog us around here for drugs
I do know they're passing the baton around, aren't they?
Well, they're saying now that they're not going to do anything until Phase 2's report is out. So Phase 2's hearings finish next month, so we probably won't get the report until 2024, 2025.
What?
We'll probably get an arrest maybe in 2020, a whole heap of nothing, because it's not going to happen.
Joe, thank you very much for this interview, man. Where can the people find you? They want to connect with you.
Email me, joe@grenfellactiongroup.com or on Twitter, Joe Defone UK.
Thank you very much, Joe, yeah?
Right, see you later.
Yeah, have a good day. Take care.
What does he say? Now I hear the angel with the seven seas.
For the moon to circulate. I stray so far from heaven. Power.